Assalamu alaikum, my name is Sania Hassan and today the topic of my presentation is the treatment of lung cancer. Okay, first I'd like to give some introduction about what are lung cancers. So basically lung cancer is the uncontrolled growth of the abnormal cells that start off in one or for both of the lungs, usually in the cells that line the air passages. The abnormal cells do not develop into healthy lung tissues, they divide rapidly or uncontrollably and form tumors. Okay, what are the risk factors that cause the lung cancers? Number one is the tobacco or the cigarette smoking, which is the number one cause. Then comes radon, which is the exposure to dangerous radiations. Asbestos exposure, asbestos is a kind of fiber which when burnt off, it gives off fumes which are very dangerous to health. Then comes pollution and then comes age. Okay, what are the types of lung cancers? The types of lung cancer, number one is the non-small cell lung cancer, which accounts for about 85% of the lung cancers, and that includes three basic carcinomas. Number one is the adenocarcinoma, which is the cancer of the outer area of the lung. And it is the most common cancer in the United States, occurs both in men and in women equally. Squamous cell carcinoma, which is the carcinoma of the center of the lung by an air tube. It accounts for about 25% of the lung cancers. Then comes the large cell carcinoma. Ye kahin any part of the lung mein hota hai and it grows more faster. Then comes the stages of non-small cell lung cancers. There are basically four stages of lung cancers. Four stages mein humare paas subdivided categories hain. Stage zero humare paas sabse initial stage of cancer hai. It happens in the innermost lining of the lung. Then comes stage one. Stage one cancers happen only in the lungs and has not spread to any other lymph nodes. Stage two, the cancer is in the lung and the nearby lymph nodes as well. Stage 3 cancer mein humare paas, there are basically, they are subdivided into 3A and into 3B. 3A category mein kya hota hai, ke the cancer has spread locally and it has spread to the lung and the lymph nodes, and but it happens in the same side of the chest or one part of the lung. In the stage 3B, the cancer has spread to the opposite side of the chest or above the collarbone also, and both of the lungs are now affected, and it is a chronic situation, a very grave situation. Stage 4 cancer is the most advanced stage of lung cancer, and it is the most advanced disease. It has spread to both of the lungs, to the fluid in the area around the lungs, and another part of the body such as the liver, heart, brain or the organs. Okay, now small cell lung cancer, which is the other kind of lung cancer, it is they tend to grow more quickly than the non-small cell tumors, but the bright side is that it is more responsive to the chemotherapy than the NSCLC. Stages of the small cell lung cancer, the number one stage is limited stage, in which the cancer happens on one side of the chest involving just one part of the lung and nearby lymph nodes. Extensive stage, as the name suggests, it has spread to other regions of the chest or other parts of the body as well. Okay, what are the treatment options? Treatment options mein humare paas sabse pehle surgery hai, then comes radiotherapy, chemotherapy, targeted therapy and palliative care. Stage-wise treatment of the non-small cell lung carcinoma or cancer. Stage 0 mein humare paas, because the cancer is not spread, it is just the lining layer of the airways. So we do not have to perform any chemotherapy or radiation therapy is also not needed. The cancer can be cured and contained by surgery alone. It is very curable. The surgeons perform segmentectomy or wedge resection. Wedge resection is the removal of a small part of the affected area, or segmentectomy is a rather larger part of the or a chunk of the lung is extracted out, which is affected. ओके स्टेज वन में क्या है, स्टेज वन इज ऑल्सो ट्रीटेड बाय, स्टेज वन इज ऑल्सो ट्रीटमेंट ट्रीटेड बाय सर्जरी, इट ऑल्सो डजेंट नीड एनी कीमोथेरेपी, बट सम पेशेंट्स डू रिक्वायर कीमोथेरेपी वेयर देयर इज अ चांस ऑफ द रिकरेंस ऑफ कैंसर. The surgeons mostly perform lobectomy so that the cancer does not reoccur. And after the surgery, the removed tissue is checked to see if there are cells, cancer cells at the edges of the surgery specimen. And if there are some cells left, then the other surgery is also performed. And another option might be the use of radiation therapy after surgery. Stage 2 के अंदर क्योंकि lymph nodes are also affected, then we first have to use chemotherapy and often along with radiation may be recommended before the surgery to try to shrink the size of the cancer or shrink the size of the tumor to make the operation easier. After surgery, the removed tissue is also checked for the positive margins, and then a second surgery might also be needed for the remaining cancer, removal of cancer. And यहाँ पे हम lobectomy करते हैं या sleeve resection करेंगे या pneumonectomy करते हैं, which is the removal of the lobectomy is the removal of the lobe, and pneumonectomy में हम क्या करेंगे, एक side of the lung निकाल देंगे if the patient can bear it. फिर स्टेज 3A के पेशेंट जो हैं, बिकॉज द कैंसर हैज नाउ स्प्रेड मोर टू द लंग्स एंड द लिम्फ नोड्स, सो वी परफॉर्म सम कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ रेडिएशन थेरेपी, कीमोथेरेपी एंड सर्जरी. फॉर दिस रीजन प्लानिंग ट्रीटमेंट और For stage 3A and SCLC often requires input from a medical oncologist, radiation oncologist and a thoracic surgeon. Treatment options depend on the size of the tumor, position in the lung, which lymph node it has spread to, overall health of the patient and how well the patient is tolerating it. Stage 3B mein humare paas ye hota hai ki it has spread to the lymph nodes that are near to the other lung or in the neck. And may also have gone into important structures in the chest. These cancers cannot be removed completely via surgery. So we need radiation therapy and chemotherapy combined with surgery. Some people can even be cured at this stage. At this stage of the treatment, patients who are not healthy enough for this combination are often required with radiation therapy alone or less often chemo alone. These cancers may be hard to treat, so taking part in the clinical trials for newer treatment may also be a good option for some patients. Treating stage 4, because it is very metastasized and it is the most advanced stage, so there is no cure. It is very hard to cure. The surgeons and the doctors, oncologists, they strive to make the person feel better after the surgery or the chemotherapy or immunotherapy, radiation therapy. The patient, we just try to make the patient live longer and make them feel better by relieving the symptoms. They are not likely to cure. They cannot be cured. It is very difficult to cure. Okay, what are the chemotherapeutic agents that we use? In the chemotherapy, cisplatin is used, gemcitabine, paclitaxel, etoposide injections, and docetaxel injections are also used. Case study mein humare paas a case study. Now we will discuss the case study. A 72-year-old female, former smoker with a history of COPD, presented for evaluation of a growing PET-positive right upper lobe lung lesion. The lesion was first discovered 4 years earlier when she had a chest CT for unclear reasons. At that time, it measured 1 centimeter in diameter and reportedly was not active on PET. No intervention was recommended. No further imaging was performed until she presented with worsening shortness of breath and cough. Repeated chest CT demonstrated that the lesion had grown and now measured 1.5 to 1.2 centimeter. CT 2 months later identified activity in the lesion with an SUV of 4.9. Biopsy results demonstrated the lesion to be consistent with NSCLC, non-small cell lung carcinoma. Given the PET CT and biopsy results, the patient was diagnosed with stage 1, a non-small cell lung carcinoma. प्लानिंग प्रोसेस में हमारे पास द पेशेंट, अब हम यहाँ पे क्योंकि न्यू मेथड्स आते जा रहे हैं तो वी विल यूज सम अदर मेथड. अ साइबर नाइफ विल बी यूज टू परफॉर्म द सर्जरी. द पेशेंट ओके, द प्लानिंग प्रोसेस में हमारे पास द पेशेंट्स ओनली प्रिपरेशन फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट वॉज अ प्लानिंग सी टी स्कैन to identify the tumor target. Implantation of fiducial markers was not required given the use of X-site lung technology. Following completion of imaging, the lesion was outlined on the scans, resulting in a gross tumor volume of about 3.6 centimeter cube. A treatment plan was created to deliver 60 GY in 3 fractions to the 75% isodose line with 8 mm tumor margins to encompass microscopic extension and targeting uncertainties using the 20 mm and 30 mm collimators. Outcome and follow-up mein kya hai? Humne ye perform kiya inke upar procedure cyber knife se and the lesion was removed. 4 months after the cyber knife treatment, the CT imaging revealed an interval decrease in the size of the lesion to less than 1 centimeter in maximum dimension. There was no noted acute complication. The patient remained asymptomatic with stable post-treatment. 11 months after the cyber knife treatment, CT imaging demonstrated no evidence of disease with only residual scarring noted and no PET positive. The patient continued to do well without any noted complications. Thank you so much. This is the end of my presentation. Hope you liked it. Thank you. Signing off, Sanyasi.